Yeah, so I'm... Hey, can you see clear?
Yes.
I want to share another dish list, which is, I think it's pretty simple, 10 minutes. We do not talk about these dishes, which I call it a garlic salted thing with the glass noodle. But you can change the glass noodle into any, like even the instant noodle or just the noodle you like. You don't have to be the... glass noodle. So what I do with the glass noodle, because it is cannot directly used, so what I use always is put some hot water or even warm water. But cold water is also good, but it is can cost more time to make it usable for the glass noodle. So I just put this one into the bowl to 1 or 2 minutes, it's enough. And I also have the shrimp. I defrozen this shrimp just maybe 1 minute ago, and I get out from the fridge. And what I also use is like several garlic. So what I do with the garlic is I try to push a little bit to make them into pieces. Okay. Yes. Then chop them. Be careful with a knife, yeah. But if you can already get some like chop the garlic, that'll be good enough. You don't need to do this by yourself. Yeah, because we don't want to make it so super complicated. So I just roughly chop it and make it as usable. Okay. Yes, okay, just like this. I think that's good enough. You don't need to be so fine granularity, and that's roughly good enough. Okay, so let me check the glass noodle. I just put like the 30 minutes ago. Yeah, it's already usable. So, and I get them out of water. Okay, so later I put them into a plate. So what I do is I first always put the glass noodle at the bottom of the plate. Sorry for the noise. And then I just put all the shrimp above the glass noodle. Okay. So far for the record, so I don't do any cutting for the video yet. It's only like 3 minutes past. So we have enough time. So I cut it 10 minutes, right? So yes, it's a little bit too much for one people. Yeah, if you have a family home, I think it's good for a family of three or two. It could be the one dish. So it is the final display. Okay, turn on the fire. And I already put some like the oil into the pan. Okay, so just 1 spoon or 2 spoon is enough. This is for the garlic shrimp. So I put the chopped garlic. And the fire should be at the medium level. I also put some onion, chopped onion. Yeah, try to mix them a little bit. Yeah, you will smell. And after maybe 6 to 10 seconds, I put some soy sauce. Soy sauce could be like 3 spoons. And I also put some white pepper and turn off the fire. Mix them with it. Okay, so this is sauce. You put the sauce on the shrimp evenly, and you don't need to be so accurate. So put them a little bit. Okay, so then the shrimp is ready to be like steamed. Yeah, steamed is perfect. So what I do is like I put some water. I don't know if you have this one. This one is to make sure the water is isolated from the pan going to the steam. Okay? After this step, you just do the largest, the highest level of the fire to steam the shrimp for 5 minutes. I think 5 minutes when it's boiling and 5 minutes that's enough. Wait, see. And also, if you can see, let me show how. The shrimp currently is still like pretty white, pretty raw, right? So when the color turns the red, then you can turn off the fire and it's ready to eat. I need is like just 2 eggs and also onion. So if you don't like onion, just forget about onion. But I also like kimchi, so I have some canned kimchi from the Amazon. If you like, you can buy it. And if you're a meat lover, I suggest you put some meat. So what I do is just preheat this frozen meat first. So it's super easy to do. So what I do is like first, you can just put 2 eggs. Okay, and put 2 eggs and into a bowl and try to mix it. I have my chopsticks. And you can use anything to mix it, like this. Sorry if it is so loud. So later, because I can only eat the egg, but I want to try to make it like the rice. So what I put is like, because we call it pancake, right? It's not an omelette. So I put some flour. But make sure it's much easier for you. I think we need to cut the onion. So I like onion because it makes the taste much more layers, like more layers rather than just simple omelette. Just cut a bit. I think cut half. Half is enough. I don't know how long it takes. It already takes 5 minutes from my. But in general, I think if you do it at home, it could be only 3 minutes to finish all these steps. And then I think meat, right? Just put all the meat you love, because I love meat. So a good way is when you have all this meat at home, when you first have a delivery from the grocery, right? And then you try to put different plastic bags. Or it's not really good right now. But you can just reuse this plastic bag and try to divide them into different small bags and just put them into the refrozen. And later you can just easily to get them out and preheat and use in different dishes you want to put them in. And you don't need to reheat everything together all the time. Okay, then just put the meat in and mix them. Okay, so the next step is to add any vegetables or any like the, even the pickles, even the kimchi. So I like the kimchi pancakes, so what I do is like, I use this kimchi. Ah, it's a little bit hard to, okay, open it. You can take a look, it's kimchi, right? So, and what I do is like, yeah, try to be kind of, yes, I put some into the egg. I got the egg soup, I don't know, yeah, it's made not called egg soup. And just mix them. Make everything, even the meat and the egg, have the flavor of the kimchi. And at the same time, I think I prefer to put some, the salt, to take care of some taste. This pepper, right? I use white pepper, you can use any pepper. To make it taste better, and mix them again. Okay.
Yes, can we see
the pan? Yes. Okay. We will wait for the shrimp to be ready. So we can here to show how I cook the pancake, super easy. So we cast, it takes like the 4 minutes to 5 minutes to do the pre-work before we do this. Then we just ready to cook. Just one spoon of the oil and try to make it a little bit all over the pan. And then we don't have any to. So that's why it's not just stick into one place. And then put the pre-pan, the meat, and the egg, and the kimchi, and also the flour into the pan evenly. Yeah, and try to do this way. And then just spread. I think use your spoon to make sure they are evenly spread over. It's not in a good shape, but it's still, yeah, I think taste should be good. I have tried this cake for 2 or 3 times, so the both taste good and looks good, but I don't know why this time. Maybe because I didn't put the water in the egg, and so it's not so like water, it can just flow into a different part, every part of the pan. But still, it looks good, and they use the medium to the large level for the fire. And let's look. So currently we just like less than 1 minute, right? But we already see, and at the same time, let's take a look on the shrimp. So for the shrimp, it already become pretty red, but let's still wait 1 or 2 minutes to make it super ready. So it is kind of, yeah, it's in really bad shape. It looks good, right? Yeah, let's wait. So after 1 or 2 minutes, when the bottom of the cake is pretty ready, you have to turn over the pancake to make sure the cover right now, the top part, is also will be cooked. So we don't eat the raw meat. Let's wait. So okay, let's go back to the omelette or pancake. It's already cooked like the 1 minute. I think the shape is pretty fixed. So when the shape is pretty fixed and a little bit hard, I have to say, then you can just try to turn over there. Let me try. Yes, I made it. So it's another 2 minutes to cook the top part of the pancake to make sure it's ready to bake. At the same time, when we see the shrimp, let me turn. I think it's pretty ready now. So I think when the color turns red for the shrimp, it's ready to bake. But to make sure if you are not sure, just make the steam a little bit longer. Okay, let's wait for the pancake now. So I think the pancake is in pretty good shape now. I think 1 minute is enough for it. So we will take a final picture of those dishes. Make sure, hey, they're good and ready to eat.